O chosen people, proclaim the mighty works of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Friends, today we celebrate the memorial of Saint Junipero Serra. Born in Mallorca, Junipero Serra joined the Franciscans in 1730. A gifted teacher, he left Spain for the Mexican missions in 1749. He was appointed superior of a group of Franciscans assigned to Alta California, now the state of California. Despite a painful leg injury, he preached Christ to the natives up and down the coast, founding the first 9 Californian missions. When the Spanish military presence threatened the economic independence of the missions, he returned to Mexico City to plead for the rights of the natives. His personal motto was, always forward, never back. Junipero died at Mission Carmel in 1784 and was canonized on September 23rd, 2015. United in faith with this holy saint of the Americas, we turn now to our Father in heaven as we acknowledge our sin. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who by your ineffable mercy have been pleased through the labors of your priest, Blessed Junipero Serra, to count many American peoples within your church, grant by his intercession that we may so join our hearts to you in love as to carry always and everywhere before all people the image of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Seek good and not evil, that you may live. Then truly will the Lord, the God of hosts, be with you as you claim. Hate evil and love good, and let justice prevail at the gate. Then it may be that the Lord, the God of hosts, will have pity on the remnant of Joseph. I spurn your feasts, says the Lord. I take no pleasure in your solemnities. Your cereal offerings I will not accept, nor consider your stall-fed peace offerings. Away with your noisy songs. I will not listen to the melodies of your harps. But if you would offer me burnt offerings, then let justice surge like water, and goodness like an unfailing stream. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Hear my people and I will speak. Israel, I will testify against you. God, your God, am I. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always. I take from your house no bullock, no goats out of your fold. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. For mine are all the animals of the forests. Beasts by the thousand are my mountains. I know all the birds of the air, and whatever stirs in the plains belongs to me. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. If I were hungry, I should not tell you, for mine are the world and its fullness. Do I eat the flesh of strong bulls, or is the blood of goats my drink? To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Why do you recite my statutes and profess my covenant with your mouth? Though you hate discipline and cast my words behind you, to the upright I will show the saving power of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus came to the territory of the Gadarenes, two demoniacs who were coming from the tombs met him. They were so savage that no one could travel by that road. They cried out, "What have you to do with us, Son of God? Have you come here to torment us before the appointed time?" Some distance away, a herd of many swine were feeding. The demons pleaded with him, "If you drive us out, send us into the herd of swine." And he said to them, "Go then." They came out and entered the swine, and the whole herd rushed down the steep bank into the sea, where they drowned. The swine herds ran away, and when they came to the town, they reported everything, including what had happened to the demoniacs. Thereupon the whole town came out to meet Jesus, and when they saw him, they begged him to leave their district. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Good morning. While our founding fathers were establishing democracy on the East Coast, Junipero Serra, our founding father in faith, was establishing the Catholic roots of California on the West Coast. Junipero Serra has been a topic of controversy these recent days, so I just invite you maybe today to read up on Junipero's life and the impact he had in faith and also the establishment of California during that time. A last-minute concert assignment forced a music critic to cancel dinner with his friends. Then the soloist's son died suddenly, causing the concert to be postponed. The critic phoned his friends saying, "Good news, the soloist's son died, so the concert is postponed." Suddenly he realized what he had said. The son's death was not good news. It was tragic news. Something similar happens in our gospel. Jesus restores two men to sanity at the cost of a few pigs. But the people are more concerned about the pigs than they are the two men. So they ask Jesus to go away. Why? Well, perhaps they were fearful of what might happen if Jesus got too close. Maybe they were too attached to their demons, pride, dependencies, comfort. Maybe they were afraid that they can't do without those comforts, dependencies, and pride. Friends, freedom in Christ is far better than hanging on to our comfortable old demons. The Lord promises that he will be with those who seek good and not evil. Relying on his promise, we bring our needs to him. We pray for Pope Francis. May the Lord bless him with strength and good health as he continues his ministry. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for lawmakers. May God guide their hearts to enact legislation that respects the dignity of all life. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for the sick and those caring for them. May the peace only Christ can bring refresh their spirit. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for members of this parish community. May the Holy Spirit inspire us in works of justice and peace. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for the faithful departed. May the angels welcome them to paradise. Let us pray to the Lord. And friends, we offer any intention which we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you are the source of all that is good. We ask you in your mercy to hear our petitions through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of your name, for our good and all of our
glory. Look upon the sacrificial gifts we offer, Almighty God, on the feast day of Blessed Junipero Serra. And grant that we who celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion may imitate what we now do. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most merciful, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I will pasture my sheep, I myself will give them rest, says the Lord. This mystery, O Lord, confirm your servants in the true faith, that they may everywhere profess in word and deed the faith for which blessed Junipero Serra never ceased to labor, and for which he spent his whole life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. And have a blessed day, everyone.
Now we are your voice, your hands, and your shall